So Fox News is, of course, covering the Trump trials. And, I mean, I guess this is what you'd expect from Fox here, but this woman is going to go into just a totally unhinged rage rant about how now she isn't proud of America because of Trump being on trial. And anyway, all right, let me shut up and just show you.
Caroline, you were in the courtroom today, too. Your observations.
Well, I will say, Sean, like millions of your viewers, I consider myself to be a proud American. But after sitting in that dirty, disgusting criminal courtroom today, watching the former president of the United States being persecuted like a criminal, I don't know if I'm so proud to be an American anymore.
Yeah, he's in a criminal courtroom because he's brought up on criminal charges because he committed said crimes. By the way, remember when Republicans flipped out at Michelle Obama because Michelle Obama said, like, for the first time in my life, I'm proud of my country? I think it was, what, when Obama got nominated or something like that? They flipped out. How dare you? You should be proud of your country all the time. Well, here we go. Now they are making the exact same argument and she loses faith because Trump. By the way, imagine being as old as she is and never being disappointed in your country to this point. Did you miss the whole Iraq war? Did you miss the torture scandal? Did you miss, hey, I know she's a partisan hack Republican. Did you miss the report on the drone strikes under Obama from Daniel Hale, where he was getting 90% the wrong people? Like, really? There's no other point where you were like, you know what? This is kind of sad. I don't like this. This is kind of sad. I mean, again, even from a conservative perspective, you weren't, I don't know, when the Supreme Court upheld Obamacare, or when John McCain upheld Obamacare. You weren't like, what is this? It's just performative virtue signaling about Trump's a victim, Trump's a victim. It's that shit.
Watching the former president of the United States being persecuted like a criminal, I don't know if I'm so proud to be an American anymore. Meanwhile, there are real criminals running free in the streets of this city every single day, being released by the same Democrat prosecutor who is going after President Trump. It is a tremendous waste of taxpayer dollars. It's a tremendous waste of time. And as I was exiting the courtroom today, I stopped by a New York police officer who was forced to stand guard and protect the courthouse. And you know what he said? He said, I am so sorry you guys have to be here. And I looked at him and I said, I am sorry you have to be here, because there is no crime that brought this case to this courtroom. It would have been laughed out of any other courtroom in America if not being brought by far left district attorney Alvin Bragg, overseen by a Democrat judge who donated money to Joe Biden's campaign.
Guys, here's why I can't take these people seriously. Here's why I can't take these people seriously. I've seen 1,000 segments like this, right? Not one of them has gone into the specifics of the case or cases. Not a single one of them has said, okay, let's go through the charges. Let me tell you why I think this charge is bullshit and that charge is bullshit and this charge is bullshit. And look, I'm okay with, you want to have a healthy skepticism? Okay, fair enough, right? But you're telling me, of the 88 criminal charges, I should say, and the 4 indictments, you don't think even one of them is legit? You think all 88 charges are bullshit and wrong? Okay, well, again, if you want to make that argument, that's a tough argument to make, but if you want to make that argument, I would love to see you break down each and every one of them and explain. This is what drove me crazy about the fraud case, too. There's a reason why I went through the indictments with a fine-tooth comb. There's a reason why I went through, like, the evidence that was laid out with a fine-tooth comb, because nobody else was doing it, and so I wanted to explain to you, like, the inner workings of every piece of fraud that Donald Trump committed, and nobody else would do it. And so what do you get? Now you get these idiots going on the media and just saying things like, oh, it's a witch hunt, and he's being persecuted, and they're treating him like a criminal, and this charge would have been thrown out if it was anybody else. Well, how many different state charges do you need, and how many different federal charges do you need from different prosecutors for you to, hey, maybe this actually isn't a witch hunt, right? Is there any set of facts where this woman would say, you know what, this isn't a witch hunt, some of this is legit? There's no set of facts. Like, you're just a partisan hack. And by the way, for anybody who might hear this and say, well, Kyle, you do the same thing, but on the other side. Wrong. You go back and watch the video when they were talking about the investigation into Hillary. And Comey came out and listed, here are the things that we found. He listed a number of crimes. Then at the end of it, he said, and we're not going to charge her. And I was like, you should fucking charge her. You just listed a number of crimes she committed. Why would you not charge her? Right? So I'm on the side of, if they commit a fucking crime, charge them. And what you see is that these people, they basically want to carve out a special zone for Trump, where it's like, whatever he does is legal by definition. And you see Trump do this too. He talks about, we need full and total presidential immunity. He'll say that in one sentence, and then in the next sentence he'll say, and we need to charge Joe Biden. But if you're talking about criminal immunity, if it applies to you, it would apply to, presidential immunity, it would apply to him too. It would apply to him too. He's also a president. Oh my God, I can't. But like, this is the sort of low effort, low energy bullshit. Like, of course this woman would be on Hannity's show. This is all he wants. Fucking catnip for his morons who watch him. It's a witch hunt against Trump. It's all witch hunt. Not a single one of them charges is legit, man. Not a single. Okay. That was a terrible accent. I don't even know what kind of accent that was.
Far-left district attorney Alvin Bragg, overseen by a Democrat judge who donated money to Joe Biden's campaign. And let's not forget why this case is being led. It's because we have a Democrat president in the White House, in Joe Biden, who is concocting all of these Biden trials behind the scenes in an attempt to interfere in this election and weaken his political opposition.
Every part of that is false. Every part of that. Biden has nothing to do with any of this shit. Literally nothing to do with any of it. And by the way, which is it? Is Joe Biden weak and senile and dementia laden and can't even put on his fucking shoes right in the morning? Doesn't know where he is. Is he that? Or is he the grand puppet master pulling the strings for this great conspiracy to take down Trump? You can't have it both ways.
What we see in banana republics, third world countries, not the United States of America. But unfortunately for the Democrats, Sean, it is backfiring on them.
If you want to talk about banana republics, a banana republic thing to do is trying to steal the last election. That's what Trump did. He had the fake elector slate, the fraudulent elector slate. That's their words, not my words. They knew it was fake. They knew it was illegal. They went forward with it anyway. Okay? That is banana republic stuff. Calling senators at the last minute saying, please reject the results of the election. Pressuring Mike Pence, trying to get him to reject the results of the election. That's banana republic stuff. Excuse me. But then she goes on to put the icing on the cake. You've all heard this point before. Ready?
President wow. Trump is tough and he's tenacious and he continues to increase his support in the polls.
Another lie. Even that's a lie. His polls have been going down for the past 3 months. How are you supposed to handle and deal with what's supposed to be a news network where every sentence, one after the next, is a bigger lie than the thing before? None of that was true. None of it. You could easily just go fucking check the polling trends. Just go check the polling trends. Trump has gone down. Oh, he's going up. He's not going up. He went up in the primary every time there was a new legal charge or indictment against him. That's true. We're not in the primary anymore. We're in the general. And his polls are going down. Look, I honestly don't think it can be overstated just how disastrous this channel is for this country. Because how many people's fucking, you know, 54-year-old uncle watches this all day, all night, at least 2 or 3 hours a day of the programming, takes it hook, line, and sinker, believes every word, thinks they're telling the truth, and everybody in the liberal media is a liar, and then this really shapes their worldview. If you want to know why we live in a country now where it's almost impossible to have a real, detailed, policy-driven conversation between a Republican and a Democrat, I think they are one of the biggest things to blame, Fox News. Because it is true that now we live in a world where there is no shared, like, well, here's the actual information, and then we could disagree on our interpretation of the information or the solution to the problems that we agree the problem is real. Now it's just they don't think the problem is real. They don't believe in the facts and the information. They just live in a totally different reality. Trump's the main character. Trump's the victim. the deep state and the Democrats are trying to take him down simply because he wants to help the American people, and they're standing in the way because they're nefarious, evil, bad. It's like, what am I supposed to do with this? I wouldn't even know where to begin trying to de-radicalize and remove the layers of propaganda. Because for some people, it's like they're going to be too far gone if they're fed a steady diet of this all day, every day. They're going to be too far gone. And I don't know how to handle that. I fancy my chances on de-radicalizing people in this, like, internet space. If, you know, maybe they were fed a steady diet of Ben Shapiro for a year, or Steven Crowder or something. There, I fancy my chances. Yeah, we'll work you out of this, right? We'll de-radicalize you. You'll understand the real information. Somebody who's a 10-year, 15-year Fox News viewer? What do I do with that? What do I do with that? I don't know. It's just total propaganda 24/7 and brainwashing so many people into believing this hero narrative about Trump, that he is being persecuted because he is the savior and the Democrats are nefarious, evil people. Not that Occam's razor, of course, is Trump is being charged criminally because he committed a lot of crimes. And if anything, he's lucky he got as far as he did without being charged. That's the two-tier justice system, is that for the longest time, even though we knew this guy was a criminal, nobody lifted a finger to try to stop him. Because he's wealthy, because he's powerful, because he's a former president. There's the two-tier justice system. He should have gone down a long, long time ago.
Hey, y'all, do me a favor and like and subscribe. It helps out big time in the algorithm. Click the bell as well for notifications when videos drop. And watch that video on screen right now. You know you want to.